Friends, good morning. Hope that you are well today. And another beautiful day from another beautiful day in New Mexico. Hope that yours is, that you found beauty somewhere in yours from wherever you are. There are lots of signs of hope as spring starts to take some form and shape. Good morning, Florence. Thanks again for the Lobo mask. I got that from Florence there. Wearing that today around church and school. We had a fun dinner last night, Karen. We had 13 Zoom tables gathered together for a time of soup and bread and other things and fellowship and worship, and I was just inspired and left humbled by all of you, so thank you. We posted some pictures, got an invitation out so for everyone to continue to join us on Wednesdays during Lent, 6 o'clock. The Zoom link, if you can't find it and you need it, connect with me or the office and we'll make sure you get it. It was emailed out yesterday. Go Laura. Yes, ma'am. My Laura is getting her first vaccine shot. Karen will get hers later today. We probably shouldn't be talking about all this stuff in public, right? It's medical things, but that's, beg your forgiveness. But it is. Those are signs of hope, and it's exciting here. So it's hard not to share that excitement. February 25th, Thursday, we're invited to consider the text for reflection from Romans here, Romans chapter 3. So if you have your Bible and you want to read along and spend some time in devotion together reading, find Romans chapter 3. If you want to just listen, I will go ahead and read it for us as we spend this time dwelling in God's word together. Romans 3, starting in the 21st verse. Let's read together. But now, apart from the law, the righteousness of God has been disclosed and is attested by the law and the prophets. The righteousness of God through faith in Jesus Christ for all who believe. For there is no distinction, since all have sinned and fall short of the glory of God. They are now justified by his grace as a gift through the redemption that is in Christ Jesus, whom God put forward as a sacrifice of atonement by his blood, effective through faith. He did this to show his righteousness, because in his divine forbearance he had passed over the sins previously committed. It was to prove at the present time that he himself is righteous, and that he justifies the one who has faith in Jesus. Then, what becomes of boasting? It is excluded. By what law? By that of works? No, but by the law of faith. For we hold that a person is justified by faith apart from works prescribed by the law. Or is God the God of the Jews only? Is he not the God of Gentiles also? Yes, of Gentiles also, since God is one, and we will justify the circumcised on the ground of faith, and the uncircumcised through that same faith. Do we then overthrow the law by this faith? By no means. On the contrary, we uphold the law. Word of God, word of life. Thanks be to God. A devotion here from Christ in Our Home today is entitled The Purpose of the Law, inviting our focus to the 31st and last verse that we read together. On the contrary, we uphold the law. A devotion from Christ in Our Home. Many people struggle with the concept of discipline in their faith life. While freedom is restricted in some parts of the world, in most of Western society, people can live as they wish as long as they don't hurt others. Yet individualism can also be our downfall. When we equate God's gift of salvation through love and grace with unconstrained freedom, we miss God's true desire for the world. It's no wonder we get confused. Paul writes to early Christians who were also unclear about the relationship between justification by faith and God's ancient law. Does salvation as a free gift of God through Jesus' death and resurrection mean we can now toss out the law altogether? They might have wondered. By no means, says Paul. In light of faith, we are neither saved nor chained by the law. Disciplined adherence to the law guides us in living out our salvation as God has always intended, as God's children in community, with compassion and justice for one another. I invite you to pray with me here. Dear Lord, help me to discipline myself according to your word. Amen. Be invited as this day unfolds before you for the prayer concern of those who work within the justice system, for those who work within the justice system, and for a bit of meditation and pondering today from A Story to Tell, which is a good devotion on forgiveness today here, which was a little bit of that first part of our reading from Romans. Be invited to ponder this today as your journey goes. It's this strange experience of being let go by someone that enables you to let go of yourself and come to be something bigger than you thought you were, realizing that it's someone else who made that possible for you. That's what I mean by being forgiven. This from James Allison in The Forgiving Victim. So ponder that as your day unfolds in prayer and devotion and hope together. We abound together. Be invited to share some time of devotion tomorrow at 9, either with Nancy Morrison or a guest, you never know. But show up at 9 and we'll spend time together, dear friends. God bless you on our continued journey.